There it is. All right, let's pray. Father, help us to wake up. We just give you thanks for your greatness, Lord. You are the one creator God of all the universe. We are in awe of you, your wisdom, your power, your compassion. Lord, the way that you have been a father to us. We had previously rebelled against you, and yet you took all this initiative to find us and reach us, to seek us out, so that you may bring us back into your family, Lord. Make us your sons and daughters, and bless us beyond our wildest dreams. We pray, Father, that you help us to think about what is so wonderful about you today, and to block out distracting thoughts, whatever else may be going on. We pray that we would come to you with our troubles, that we would come to you with our praise and gratitude, and that we would open our minds and hearts to learn from you and be transformed into the image of Jesus Christ this day. We give you thanks. And Lord, we pray regarding a couple of things that are going on in our country, Lord. It is distressing to see a large demonstration of white supremacists in Charlottesville, Virginia. It's distressing that people would openly meet in such a way. And it's distressing to those of us who tend to be more politically conservative that they would ever try to associate themselves with the right, so to speak. But Lord, their hatred is their own and not ours, and their hatred is abominable, and it's just needing to be condemned and needing to go no further. We pray that such hatred will not spread. We pray, Father, for this divisive time. We pray for civility. We pray for peace between political opponents. We pray for a great calming of the tensions between left and right in this nation. But we pray, Lord, for an end to racism in our country. And we also pray, Lord, that these tensions between us and North Korea would not go any further. We pray that no one would push the button and launch nuclear weapons at anybody. We pray, Lord, that both sides would just sort of tamp down the rhetoric and that this crisis would be done away with via the threat averted. We pray, Lord, also, we've been praying that North Korea wouldn't get nukes, but it appears they have them now, and they have at least medium-range intercontinental ballistic missiles and the ability to mount nukes on such missiles. We don't want them to have that. We want somehow, some way, for them to not have that kind of power, because we don't want to have to sleep with one eye open about a rogue nation of that sort. We just pray, Father, for a real resolution to this nuclear crisis that doesn't involve lives being lost. Father, we just pray for peace and we pray for stability. These are things that we ought to be praying for, Lord. We ought to pray for peace and justice, as Scripture so often portrays. So we pray, Lord, for the well-being of the people of our world. We pray for your kingdom to come, your will to be done on earth as it is in heaven, and that we would be the peacemakers that you have called us to as your people. We thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated.